and it's called Life.
Las Ramblas for some tapa.
Look, get off the bike and do.
Fancy lines. Already know you. If you need.
You are locked into 107.3 FM Represent Radio on a Tuesday drive time, 5 until 7pm. You are cruising with Caramel. And right now, three lovely ladies who refer to themselves as live from Layfield. Ladies, how y'all doing?
We're doing fine.
Yeah, y'all looking on fleek, girl. So, first things first, how do you guys know each other?
We met at uni.
Uh-huh.
So, we all study pharmacy.
Pharmacy?
Yeah, we study pharmacy. Wow. So we met in first year. We thought Beverly was a bit stiff at first, but you know.
Oh, wow. So you were throwing shade at Beverly. So Beverly wasn't in the cool gang?
No.
Well,
she thought she was in the cool gang.
She's in her own cool gang.
Goodness, Beverly's getting ripped into. I feel like I need to jump in.
Evie's always wanted to do YouTube.
Yeah.
And in second year, she was just like, we should all do it. And I thought, no.
How did you?
In our friendship group, that's what we talk about. We talk about everything. Yeah. So we said, why not bring it to YouTube?
Yeah, and we realised that a lot of people don't have friendship groups that can encourage them or give them good advice. People are just doing what their friends are doing.
That's interesting. Why do you think that is?
I think society makes it easier to like follow with the crowd rather than just being yourself.
A little discussion about sort of, you know, how you guys would describe yourself. And there was an emphasis on, we want to kind of be like big online sisters. And we want to appeal to a younger audience who might need that guidance.
Yeah.
That's pretty profound, considering that most people go into YouTube and they're like, I'd love to be a viral video. I have done just about anything to become viral on YouTube. None of it has worked. So who came up with the idea of, let's try and encourage people that are younger than us?
I was just like, I don't really want to do it for like beauty and things. That's not what I'm into. And Uvia was just like, no, like we're just going to be ourselves on YouTube.
Yeah.
And I was like, if I was to do it, I would want to like talk about different things. And she was like, yeah, that's exactly what would be like. Then we told Zoe about it. She's like, yeah, you know. Yeah, yeah. So it wasn't anything that anybody needed to persuade anyone.
And it's called Life Advice with the Layfield Girls. So what I've done is I found a collection of problems that, you know, man's out here experiencing. And they need some advice. Ladies, first of all, it's a scorching hot summer's day. Okay, 33 degrees minimum. The person in question is on a date, all right, a picnic date. You're out and about, you're in the sun. Okay. Okay, he's already got the grey top on. That's not good news.
Terrible.
Sweaty mistake.
Okay, it's a sweaty mistake. Now, all of a sudden, this dude realises he didn't shower since the night before.
Is he bluffing? What kind of date is this?
He didn't put any deodorant, because the thing is, he'd just gone to the gym, so he didn't know he was having a date. That the date is from the gym. It's the caretaker. Yeah.
What?
So now, okay, he's got no deodorant on. He's not showered. He also accidentally forgot to brush his teeth because he was waiting to get a special offer on Colgate. He forgot to get a special offer on Colgate. But the thing is, he's a nice guy. Okay. Now he wants to do damage control. Does he tell the girl exactly what's gone down? Because there's a chance that, you know, there might be some level of intimacy. Or what can possibly be, I'm just saying.
There will be no levels.
What can possibly be done?
My advice is you need to pretend you get a phone call and get the hell out of there.
Yeah.
Okay, that's quite a good advice.
ASAP.
Who would the phone call? Because the girl's going to ask questions. You know
she
is. Who's the phone call from?
His younger brother.
No.
What does he want?
It's an emergency. Yo, what happened? Oh, this person got bored. I'm coming.
I would say, just be honest, mate. Just be like, you know what? Just came back to the gym. I was a bit sweaty, to be honest. I haven't had a chance.
He hasn't brushed his teeth.
Listen, you don't have to go as far as saying you haven't brushed your teeth. That's just, you know.
It's just a give. If you haven't washed your armpits, you haven't brushed your teeth. It's just like the two are usually connected.
But you can just, I just came out from the gym. I didn't want to leave you hanging. So obviously, can we meet up a little bit later?
Yeah.
So after he gets a phone call from his brother.
Yeah.
Straight away there, he reorganises. So I'm going to come back in the evening around 9 p.m.
I like that.
I'm
a contingency plan.
From your house.
Contingency.
That way, you know, it seems like he's got.
Do you know what?
I don't think she can get above six purely based on the fact
copyright.
That she's copyright.
Okay. We've got a six in the corner. I'm sorry. Okay, there's always a chance. Okay, we've got 8.5. And then Zoe's taking around 8.7. Okay, that's just the first round. After linking you on WhatsApp. You find yourself hanging out with a delectable young gentleman.
Delectable, okay. Wow, this is interesting.
Smooth, he's as smooth as a melted galaxy bar.
Chocolate.
Yeah, he's funny, he's smart, he's loquacious.
Loquacious?
Can we have a definition of that, loquacious?
Loquacious means when you talk, it just sounds nice.
Okay.
Just sounds loquacious.
All right,
he drives with Benz.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm basically describing myself here.
But okay.
I'm saying, well, that's all I'm saying. Okay. However, you're hanging out, okay, you're chatting, you're really getting to know each other, you're sharing your deepest stories, like he knows your secrets, he knows your insecurities, and at the end of the meeting, he looks at you and he goes, do you know what? I'd really love you to meet my girlfriend one day.
What you say? That you only
meant well, cause you did. Girls, what needs to happen in this situation?
What?
What needs to happen? Write that guy off.
Immediately, some prayer needs to take control of this. I mean, the first thing is we'll be like, okay, so when were you planning on telling me while you're inside my WhatsApp chat that you had a girlfriend, mate? That's my first question.
But then he looks around and he says, well, I just wanted to, you know, I thought we were good friends, that's all.
Good friends? Like, so how did you approach me, mate? What's all of this? I leave him with a positive statement. Friendly okay. vibes, you know, but you'd never hear from me again.
Okay, all right.
That's 100%.
That's good. I like that. That's firm but fair.
Okay, cool. So I have to stick true to myself. This is not about points anymore.
okay. It never was about points.
It was about points. Okay, so as you tell me that you have a girlfriend, all I have to say is that's very nice. What we call my load. That is my jacket, my shoes. And you can have a nice life. I will just say that's very nice. I'll start picking up my stuff turning around.
I'm actually going to be so dumbfounded. So, and then I'll repeat everything you said to me. So you mean to say that you was talking to me on WhatsApp.
Oh no, so you do the replay.
And then,
you do the instant replay.
And make sure I haven't misunderstood what's happened. And now we are here, after how many so hours, is now that you want to tell me, okay, thank you, my friend, congratulations. Thank you for the entertainment, and I'll be off.
What? For the entertainment.
This week, it was really warm, so I thought, let's take advantage of this warm weather. And I said, obviously, we live in London. We've never actually been on like the Barclays bikes, which is disgraceful. So let's make a day of it. So I've organized a whole day. Yeah, it's gonna be a fun day. I've got like some prizes. Like, I don't really tell them what we're doing. And obviously, if I'm planning an event, like, there has to be something different and it has to be food. If you haven't been on Snapchat, you know about that food life. Anyway, I'm actually so bold. Like, I'm talking to this thing and everyone watching me. Anyway, Sha. Check it out later. Bye.
Hi guys, so I'm here in some different kind of location. I don't know where Uge has told me to come to, but I have a feeling it's salsa dancing, because I said to somebody outside, do you work here? And then they'll just like, no, but my friend told me to come here. So Uge, when you see this, it's not like car chairs. But yeah, I'm here now, I'm just waiting for them to come.
So this is where I brought everyone to. It's 90 Charing Cross Road. Zoe is the only person that's on time, as always. And yeah, let me show you what's going on up in here. So, today we have come to a salsa class.
Samba do you now, Samba do.
This is the place.
Delicious dressing with her curly hair. Hey! Everyone's here doing couple looking at me. I'm thinking, why is everyone looking at me like, what's going on, mate? I just come in, my friend's coming.
It's a saucy place, you know what I mean? It's saucy.
And I'm wearing a trouser, looking like a video backup dancer. Like,
y'all seeing this goddess we got up in here. Okay, she bumped the whole back.
Yeah,
she bumped the whole back.
And this is some angles, okay. Yo. How do you find the background in this dress?
You know, just whatever. I was like, I have to take off my underwear because I'm sick.
Guys, she's the one that organized this whole thing. She should have come in the most appropriate attire.
It's been a very hectic day.
It's this EVA, like.
It's been a very hectic day for me.
Where's everybody? Because I like to be on time. Have fun. Have fun. Okay. Have fun.
Guys, I'm proud insane.
Down.
So easy. Let's go again. 3, 2, 1, and go.
So we're getting some Barclays bikes, guys. I've got mine already, waiting for these tricks. I'm gonna ride around London, yo.
Can you hurry up, please?
Yes, I can. Look at this rat.
People are struggling.
Seat's so high.
Simple bike, they can't do. Put that seat down, please.
Did you break your arm in here?
Look, get off the bike and do it. Natasha.
I'm in there.
So you're like, go and start marching around. You're gonna struggle.
Magella, though, can you even get on the bike?
No.
I have to adjust the seat, so I'm short girl.
Squat, can you ride a bike? Look, you're struggling.
Man, like, bee bags, that's right.
It's like a path from some road, but not on all the roads. It's dangerous, that's what it is. From Leicester Square to Shoreditch, Box Park right here. I am tired.
It's nice.
Look at this girl after she took the train, she even ride the bike. You're a mess.
F off.
No, you should be embarrassed.
I feel like we're on holiday.
Yeah. Giving some Spanish.
Salsa.
You even miss the salsa yourself.
Yeah. How's your day been, guys? It's been
amazing.
Shut up, you're
on
the bus.
I can't believe it. I can't believe my mouth. I'm really embarrassed for you.
When I got the train, innit?
No.
When I got the train.
Come on, your fears.
Never.
What? It's only a bike.
You know what? Wait. Next week, but then I squad a bike.
We'll see. Do we come here again? Like, you perform this again? I can't abandon the friendship.
No, she was breathing hard. Breathing hard. Like, heavy.
You know, I was scared.
I was breathing like. Already know you,
if you need. Today we're gonna do the ramen challenge. So I got the 5-pack of noodles, and Beverly is not actually gonna participate because she is a loser. But today we have Natasha. Natasha, don't get in. And we have Nancy.
I'm coming. Hi guys.
And so we're gonna make these and we're gonna come back. For once, this actually wasn't my idea. It was Zoe's idea, but I happily co-signed it. And the rules are, the first person to finish it wins. Oh yeah, like I said, Beverly, she's just there, just behind the camera.
Yeah, sure.
Girl,
I wanna recognize when I see
you. Get out the screen. All right. You ready, guys?
I'm sweating.
Yeah. You ready, guys?
I'm actually scared, yeah.
My armpits are so hot right now.
Any final words, though?
Oh, I've got a cough, like I'm actually ill. So if I need to escape, it's because the pepper has entered my trachea rather than my esophagus.
And we have no milk to help this situation.
Trachea.
Okay. Three, two.
Oh, God.
Okay.
Blood time. It's not bad.
Mm. Well, mom has made spicy stews.
Yeah.
Oh, it is so much.
Yeah, I was trying to eat really quick. I realize that sugar's throwing down. It's okay, hold on. I'll take my time.
How about the flavour?
Mm-hmm.
This is alright.
Calm.
Maybe you got something wrong.
Who did this challenge and said it was bad?
Many people.
They're liars.
This is pointless.
Come on, EVA, because you're now throwing away food.
I'm enjoying the food, so mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm hungry.
Guys, you're gonna have to step up for African people because we eat pepper like
this. It's a joke.
I'm enjoying this food, yeah. To be honest. Has actually quite a good amount of pepper. Pepper, you could have done this, you know?
I haven't.
The level's gonna increase or something.
No, but I'm really enjoying this. It's tasty.
This is your average pepper soup.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
This is not even a challenge. I'm not the racist to beat anyone. You go ahead.
There was one seed that I bit that really.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, wow.
Exploded.
It really exploded. Wow.
This is a joke.
My face does feel a little bit hot though.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a side effect? So Nancy, why are you drinking then?
You're just thirsty at this point.
Do you know what I mean? Wow.
I'm Zoe, what are you?
This is Zoe for you anyway.
I'm genuinely hungry. I just served me a delicious meal. What? I'm gonna finish that quickly.
I really did the most, you know.
Really?
Yeah, so.
Oh, that was a
fail.
Anticlimax.
That was it.
I'm starting to feel some heat in the back of my throat.
So, slightly concerned.
My tongue is burning, I can't lie.
But she didn't want to pry apart.
No, it's just started to... my mouth, the back of my tongue, like, it's like...
Really?
Flame.
It's more my mouth that's burning.
No, my tongue is on fire right now.
Is there like a delayed effect?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
I say we wait.
Guys!
Brothers. My top lip is a bit tingling, mm-hmm. but...
Because you got a bit of orange residue.
Yeah, that's awesome.
My lip, bro. I was really opening my mouth. I was trying not to ruin my lips, so I haven't got any on my lips. It's just my tongue.
My mouth is hot.
Guys,
my mouth is hot.
My tongue.
What I thought it was going to be like.
I thought it was going to ruin my life.
Like watering eyes.
Yeah, people have really been
coughing,
dying.
So are they just doing it for you two then?
I think
just faking it.
Yeah, actively.
Because if I'm seeing Nigerian people do that, our mum's definitely cooked more pepper than this.
Yeah.
What, have Nigerian
people done it? Yeah, black people have done this.
But maybe their mum's just like, cooked pepper.
No.
It's not possible. There's something, mum, I can't even eat the food.
This is not.
No, but my mouth is hot. My
tongue is hot.
And my gum. And your eyes are.
You're looking
at my eyes.
And my gum is soft.
Your eyes are looking a bit more moist.
What, mine?
Yeah.
Wow.
I think out of everybody, Uwe is the genuine most calm.
Yeah, Uwe.
I think you are filming it for the camera. Inside your tea red.
No, I'm actually not.
And
my tongue is burning.
Is Natasha.
That's burning, guys. But I'm alright.
Is it?
I promise.
Swear.
Shut up over there, you couldn't even do it.
Yeah.
You're right.
Just say, Natasha, speak your mind.
It's just a lower lip, that's really it. That is really like, as my mum is, you know what I'm saying?
Well, that's it for now, guys.
Yeah, we had a bit of an after reaction, so it was a delayed response.
And okay. Does that even count?
It doesn't even count.
For what I was expecting. What a joke.
I was expecting someone to launch over there.
Yeah.
Like,
chaos.
Yeah.
What? Come and see apples, this guy says grapes. My God.
Look.
The grapes is called apples.
My God!
No, they're actually quite big. They are quite big.
What?
They are actually quite big.
Apples disguised as
grapes. Pretty much, we're about to make a freak shake. So we didn't buy chocolate sauce. We're just gonna make it with Nutella. And what you have is warm milk, and you have the Nutella, and then you stir it in. It looks terrible. It looks so. This is what it looks like now. It's a bit more runny. It looks a bit more dark chocolate, I must say.
A bit more appealing to the eye.
It is a bit more appealing. Yes. It's an Oreo milkshake, by the way. Ice cream, Oreo.
Use a claw technique, guys.
Claw technique. We have right here is some normal breadsticks, Italian original to be specific. And we have Nutella sauce. We have two different types, so a bit of a thicker one and a light one. Dan is Evie has dipped the top into the Nutella, and now she's going to give it a light drizzle.
Gosh, doing this one-handed is a bit techie. This is not going to work.
Yeah, I respect the grad.
It's gonna fall!
Just on the side.
And lean it, push it onto it. Oh, sugar! It came.
Been a long day. We've had to film. We've been filming from like 9, and I'm super tired, but I have to go to my good friend Esther's graduation party. It is like 6, and am I in nursery to be going to parties at 6? But she wants the day ones to be there quite early, so that's what I'm doing. But the funny thing is, it's not really funny. She wanted everyone to wear white, right? Cool. So I brought a white, like, Greek place, giving you all types of Greek goddess, like, servage, slage, yes? And then when I took the dress out, when
when I took the place, I realised that there was like an oil stain on the bum bit. So I was thinking, what is all of this? I thought, okay, let me see what I can do. See if I can get some, like, make an intentional wedgie and conceal some of the oil patch, because this is the only white thing that I've brought. And I tried it on. No intentional wedgie could conceal that oil patch. So I'm really pissed off, because I really liked that play suit, number one. And number two, no white stuff. So I've just had to resort to this black jumpsuit and white watch. It's all I could manage.
There's a storm here, fabulous, yeah. Tweet, yeah, yeah. Shorty, I strictly wanna spank you. The most out in the morning, rushing for work and screaming, oh my, F-A-B-O-L-O-U-S. Each night I'm freaking, yeah. Nah, you ain't gonna talk me to death, cause you got free nights and weekends. Get off.
Guys, we're gonna miss our flight, like, we're running. My sunglasses! I'm gonna miss our flight! Oh, cracking!
For my brother to come and let my other friend Emmanuel, so then we can go through the security bit. Yeah,
okay,
I'll just see what suggestions.
So, can I not fly? Just let you know now,
all of these mosquito airlines, I don't
like
them.
Put a note
I like
on
to fly Virgin, you know, big airlines be because you have space, there's TVs. But I was just literally sitting there, like, trying to sleep, so uncomfortable. Yeah. But yeah, we're here now.
How was your flight?
It was good. We got some good seats right next to the door. I'm like, y'all, 12 seats.
Emmanuel, Tom Cruise, how's your flight?
Oh my god, it's just like a great experience, and I'm just so happy to be back to my people.
We can't check in till 12:30, so we have to linger on the street, and it's currently like 10 o'clock in the morning, so we're gonna get breakfast. It's Tom Cruise. So.
We're going to underground, so we're going to go find somewhere to eat for 2 hours, and then we'll go to our apartment, and I'll show you our apartment then. I think you buy your tickets here.
We are on the metro. Hey man, your smile is so pasty. It's disgusting. What's this kinky curly, Emily? You're sporting... Sorry. This is
the natural wave.
Sorry. Natural Brazilian wave. Deep wave. Yes, you will pay for this.
So these guys went to go and buy some minerals. African Fanta. Look at the colour, looking, what's that thing, fluorescent. So Tom Cruise is here.
Hey.
Hey.
It's really good.
Thank you. Your nostalgia. Now you want to like aim there, right?
Right.
So. You know, like that. Good lighting here, though. Y'all, where are we going?
Las Ramblas, man.
Las Ramblas? We're going Las Ramblas for some tapas.
What chicas?
Chicas tonight.
Don't want chicas. You
know what?
Chicas
over
there.
Chicken.
You know, women feel better approaching men when they're with other women. Did you know that?
Is it like a fact or something?
Yeah. Statistically? No, I'm trying to share. But women feel more comfortable approaching men who are with women.
How do you guys feel about the engagement tomorrow? Are you guys excited?
Oh my god, it's gonna be the best day of my life.
Right.
Yeah, it's really good. Hey Nostalgia, how do you feel about the engagement?
Yeah, love's a beautiful thing.
Just
I think it's gonna be fun. Hopefully we can pull the plan together, but it's a bit nerve-wracking. There's a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
And my cousin's literally brought us here, like, and we're all like, let's turn up, yeah, let's go out. Like, okay, right. we've actually got a job to do. It's ridiculous.
People, they're hustling all times of day. This is like, what time is it? Like 9?
10:30. That was so close, sorry. That was huge.
Sorry, a documentary.
It's so anything. Football shorts, the sunglasses, the fake handbag. You should see that holding ropes.
Yeah.
The police here come to pull up ropes, kind of like a kite.
Yeah, you're amazing.
They hold back, throw it over, they just want to move. But everything's fake, everything's counterfeit.
So
they open a bar ring.
Is this Ramblers here?
Get some deals, bargains.
Is this Ramblers?
Quality products is not product. Products is not quality.
This is Patron. I'm Patron's wife. And then we have Blackie.
This is Tata.
And I'm Blackie number two. Tata, Tata.
Tata,
Pablo, Pablo, Pablo. This is like 10:30, guys. In Spain, there's something called siesta that everybody comes up after they.
Oh, question, like, you can't even fit the camera. Hey, lifers. I mean, lifers. Yeah, so we're in a restaurant right now. Just bear with when the phone's sideways, because the camera's like not in there.
Yeah.
Like over there.
Just look at yourself.
Oh, yeah, we're just getting the drinks in and little snacks, tapas and that. Emily, Zoe, White, Emmanuel. So.
Hey guys, I just want to say,
Tom,
we don't want to say anything, but I'm the newest member of the Life of Patience.
Oh my god, guys, we can tell you, Emmanuel the greatest is joining us.
Yeah,
oh
so it's going to be an amazing experience. I just want to say thank you for my fans. And
so wait, so next week is going to be a new episode?
Next week, yeah.
Yeah, so back to me. This menu's kind of crazy, like, shmelmy.
This is squid. What's good with kimoji sauce? Kimoji, you know?
Kimoji sauce.
It's emoji sauce. And this is Emily's bread. And then there's tapas. I'm waiting for the rest of the food to come.
Who is that?
Grilled squid. Ooh, I like popping! Yeah! This is what we have to deal with.
Fraternity brothers.
Fraternity brothers.
No, I haven't seen you in 10 years.
No! My god!
Come on, where do you work at?
I work everywhere.
What the fuck do you spell fraternity? Fraternity. Is that it?
Right now we're going to the shops. We're going to go and get some bits and bobs in order to... Emily's bloody Turkish flip-flops.
Caused us so much trouble.
Caused us so much bloody work in the whole neighbourhood. Yeah, so we're going to get some last bits and bobs for the surprise. We got tired, we had like 3 hours sleep.
Really?
3-4. We went to sleep at 5 o'clock.
No,
we never went to 5. Okay,
there's
3. Do you think the shop will be open?
I don't know, check.
Oh my god. Oh my god, I hope the shop is open. We will be screwed. I think that shop will be closed. No! So today is the day, today's the day. And we're just trying to prep. So we've got like champagne glasses. Here, we've got all the rose petals and stuff there, we've got the camera ready. We've got the champagne we got from the... Oh, I'm only covering it. Got the champagne. And so we're just gonna try head over to the beach quickly, get things sorted. Just waiting for everyone to get ready, get there. Probably won't be able to eat anything, but we just have to be able to position ourselves so we can catch it on the camera and not be seen, which is difficult because it's an open beach. I don't know if I showed you guys the balcony. Back here in our room and on to it. Oh, it's so hot, my god. Look at my face. Glistening. Looks like Nigeria back here.
Hello, dear.
Just getting really rough. We're on the move. We've had a bit of a delay because everyone's just getting ready, so we've had to tell Mecca to stall. This is so intense because we haven't had a run through. I'm actually just panicking. Like, we have to make sure it looks right because
you have to
find a space. Like, it's just so nerve-wracking. Mate, I just can't with this. I start too much.
So we found a spot on the beach. My hands are even shaking now. I don't know if it's because of hunger. I'm going to put this in a rose heart. Emily's just adding some white ones.
I'm not sure if I like the white.
You don't like it?
Maybe add the pink. We'll use the white for the around the glasses. Look at it. Stand back and have a look. And see what you think.
I mean, it just all looks romantic to me, you know?
Guys, I can't explain to you. It's like 29 degrees. The sun is beating down on our backs like we're some villagers. Then we can add the rest, leftover red ones by the bottle as well.
Yeah, she looks like she's a tourist. Like.
Right, so we've left Emily there because otherwise my brother's girlfriend will notice me and will notice my brother and Emmanuel because she knows them more. So Emily's going to stand around, stay close, she can take pictures. And we're going to go and hide in a secret location. Nerve-wracking! How are you guys feeling? Like, excited now?
Well, we are excited for our brother to be proposing to his girlfriend today. It's going to be a special moment.
Guys, they're here, like, I don't think you can be able to see them. Should we hide behind the block? Hey, Rosie, just turn around. Guys. He's nervous. Done. Emeka, how are you feeling?
Tired. Exhausted.
Mentally exhausted.
Grateful.
I never experienced it. If you're excited, Emeka. Are you happy? Are you grateful?
I'm very happy. Very grateful.
I think it's a bit of a surprise for you because you didn't know what you're gonna come to, do you know what I mean? Hola. You didn't know what you're looking for. This guy.
You have done well. Speechless still. But I knew I could trust you,
though. We were stressed, bruv.
She was stressed.
I was so stressed. I was bugging out.